Morning students, and last time we have discussed about the design of Sharda Fall, various steps of design of Sharda Fall. In this step we move towards our next step. These are the design for cistern. So cistern, in the design of cistern, length of the cistern, it is taken as 5 root square root of E cross HL, where E, you can know the this is a E. What is E? E is the length, height of the crest wall to crest level to upstream total energy level. This is known as capital E. And where if we are neglecting the velocity approach, means full supply level to the height of full supply level to the total energy line, then E becomes approximate equal to capital H. Then length of a cistern equal to 5 root H cross HL. And the depth of the cistern, it is given by this formula. Okay. Similar. If we neglect the velocity approach, then E becomes capital H, then it is converted into this formula. Next step is impervious floor. Okay. So there are several points about impervious floor. First point is total length of the impervious floor. Then in this condition, we will calculate maximum seepage head, HS. HS is nothing but it is the depth of the crest wall, similar to the depth of the crest wall, and calculated in downstream side. So it is calculated as crest level minus downstream bed level. Okay. So if we move towards our diagram, then this distance, this height from downstream bed level to FSL, okay, sorry, crest level. So crest level and difference between crest level and downstream bed level, it is known as maximum seepage head. Okay, and it is equal to small d, you can see here. Okay, so next point about impervious floor is we will calculate length of the downstream floor. So length of the downstream floor, it is given by LD equal to twice of D2 plus 1.2 plus HL. D2, what is D2? D2 is the water depth in the channel at downstream side. Okay. All those calculation we will calculate in our next lecture. We will take a solid example to understand these design steps. Okay, and the length of the upstream floor, it is calculated as small b minus LD plus B1. LD, what is LD? LD is the length of the downstream floor, and B1 is the bottom width of the crest wall. And what is a small b? Small is the total length of the impervious floor. Okay, confirming from real diagram, real figure, you can see here, this is the small b from here to the here. Okay, means upstream cutoff wall to the downstream cutoff wall, this distance is known as width of the, or you can say length of the impervious floor, and it is bifurcated in various component LD, okay, LU, B1, okay, B1 means bottom width of the crest wall. Okay, so move to the next point, thickness of the impervious floor. Okay, it is given by the thickness of the downstream concrete floor is calculated from residual uplift pressure denoted by HR, and from which we can get found from subsoil HGL, hydraulic gradient line, using Bly's theory. So this is formula from Bly's theory, small t, which is the thickness of the impervious floor, and taken as hr upon g minus 1. Capital G, what is capital G? Capital G is the specific gravity of the material used in crest wall. Here, important point is, if we don't know about what is the formula, what will be the value of this thickness of downstream concrete floor, then we can write a minimum thickness of 0.3 to 0.4 meter is usually provided. Then provide minimum thickness 0.3 to 0.4, then question will be correct. Okay. Okay, so this is as per Bly's theory. And if we move towards Khosla's theory, this formula is valid for small discharge, and for large discharge and high falls, Khosla's theory is used, which is the formula taken from equation number 23.40. Okay, we will see here. We will use further this value for calculating the thickness of the downstream concrete floor. Okay, so fourth point is cutoff wall, where we will provide cutoff walls are provided at the upstream and downstream ends of the impervious floor. This is the location of cutoff walls, and the thickness of this cutoff wall is usually get 30 cm, means 1.5 brick thick. Okay, and minimum depth of upstream cutoff wall, it is calculated by this formula d1 upon 3 plus 0.6 meter. These all formulas are empirical formula. We need not to change anything else in this formula. And simply at downstream side cutoff wall, the depth of the minimum depth of cutoff wall, it is calculated by this formula d2 equal to capital d2 plus 0.60 meter. Okay, next point is a roughening device. So it is not necessary to calculate this point. And next one is, from roughening device, if we calculate this roughening device, then it is provided by two types, by using friction blocks and by using cube blocks. Okay, so if we move towards the friction block, then width and height, it is given by twice of DC and DC respectively, where DC is the critical depth of flow. So 2DC, what is 2DC? Spacing between blocks, and 1.5DC, distance of the first row of blocks from the downstream toe of the crest wall, and spacing between two rows of blocks is taken as DC. In case of cube blocks, we will use the width and height 0.1 d2, okay, and spacing between blocks 0.1, another again 0.1 d2, and spacing between two rows is again 0.1 d2. So it is very simple. Okay, so let's move towards downstream protection. Next point, there are two types of downstream protection we will use in channel section in Sarda type wall. First one is bed protection, and second one is side protection. In bed protection, dried bricks are generally used for pitching or stone pitching, brick pitching or stone pitching. And in dry pitching, it consists of 20 cm thick bricks. Okay, so sorry, in dry bricks, okay, 20 cm thick. Pitching is done by 20 cm, and in this bed production, there is no mortar is used. Okay, and bricks are placed on a 10 cm thick brick ballast. So this is the base of this bed production, base preparation for this bed production. Okay, and the length of the bed pitching and the number of curtain walls, this is given by in table 23.2, length of the downstream pitching. Okay, you can see here length of the downstream pitching, head over crest, it is given here. Total length of the downstream pitching and curtain wall, number of curtain wall, horizontal sloping wall, curtain walls in depth, meter. Okay, what is HL? HL is height of the drop and taken in meter. Okay, so the length of the bed pitching should be taken from the table, from this table, or we can use thrice of D2. Okay, so next point is upstream wing wall. Okay, there are two cases. If discharge is lesser than 14 qmax, then upstream wing walls or downstream wing, upstream wing walls is splayed straight at an angle 45 degree, means ratio becomes 1:1. Okay, for trapezoidal case, if discharge is greater than equal to 14 qmax, then upstream wing walls are segmental in plan. Okay, and with a radius of 5:6 and subtending an angle 60 degree at the center. So these are the specifications for providing upstream wing wall. We have to use these all specification in designing. Okay, so next point is downstream wing wall. What is downstream wing wall? The downstream wing wall are kept vertical for a length varying from, this is the value, 5√EHL to the 8√EHL from the crest wall. Okay, and the vertical side slope is should be provided 1:1 or 1.5:1 for downstream side protection. On the downstream of the warped wing walls, the downstream side protection is provided on the side of the channel. Okay, and the length of the side protection should be at least thrice of D2, and the side pitching is curtailed at an angle 45 degree from the end of the bed pitching in plan. Okay, so next one is profile wall. A profile wall should also be provided here. And what is the specification for this? Is provided at the end of the side pitching to retain the side pitching. Okay, this act as a protection wall. And that, what is toe wall? A toe wall is provided between the bed pitching and the side pitching. Okay, and the toe wall is about 0.3 meter thick or 0.5 D2, and depth is 0.5 D2. You know very well about what is D2. So this is all about design steps regarding the design of Sarda fall. We will meet next lecture with a suitable example based on this Sarda fall. Thank you.